Welcome to episode 599, WuJihan, King of Bitcoin Mining and Blockchain Billionaire at Age 33. This is an outline of episode 599. There are four reasons we study Wu Jihan. First, he's the king of cryptocurrency mining. Second, it only took him 6 years to become a billionaire. Third, he translated Nakamoto Satoshi's Bitcoin white papers into Chinese in 2011. Fourth, he's only 33 years old. Let us meet Wu Jihan.
If you look at the mining world, you have become one of the biggest deliverers of hardware for the mining. How did you do that? What were the decisions you took while you now have 60% market share?
It's about very fast delivering on time on the market, and it's also about to reduce the overall cost of the miners. It requires lots of hard work and lots of engineering wisdoms. We go through a long journey to achieve this.
He was born in Beijing, China in 1986. In 2009, he graduated from Beijing University, one of the most prestigious universities in China, with a dual degree in psychology and economics. He was 23. Upon graduation, he worked as an investment analyst for a private equity firm, where he discovered Bitcoin. In 2011, Wu translated Nakamoto Satoshi's white paper into Chinese.
And what did your partner do, and what was your role? I mean, we know you as the one who translated the white paper of Satoshi into Chinese, I think.
Yeah.
And what was his input?
Yeah, actually, I think I'm kind of the business guy or the idiots in this company, and my partner's doing the very complicated ASIC chip design and all the R&D management for this company. So that's how I do, I just traveling around the world and meet with people, and my partner's doing the design.
Now, he co-founded his company Bitmain in 2013 at the age of 27.
The company was started with me and my partners in 2013.
This is a picture of his partner, Zhan Micree, who's 7 years older than him.
I invited him to a dinner, and I described this idea and sent him some reference article on Wikipedia and the Bitcoin white paper. And my partner just take a 2 hours reading, and he decided this is a very good idea. This is definitely the thing he wanted to join with me and do it together. And that's how Bitmain started.
Let's take a peek into a secret Bitcoin mining factory in China. By 2017, income of coin mining has reached $2.5 billion. Let's take a look at the coin mining machine. This is the Antminer S9 model. It costs about $3,000, and it forms the lion's share of the profit of Bitmain.
Apparently greatest model. It's an ASIC miner review, and I couldn't be more excited. We're going to be reviewing the latest Bitcoin miner. To be clear, it actually does have a couple cool features. It is using Bitmain's, kind of newer power supply model, where they're building, it's really two different power supply modules here. this board, which I'll go ahead and unscrew that here to show you. Or I meant to say on the control board, which is going to be this top piece right here. But you can see that this PCIe connection is actually ran from a extender, so it's inside. If you do want to see stuff like that, please let me know in the comment section below, along with your Bitcoin address. And you know, furry donors are gonna be sending out some furry Bitcoin here, maybe at the end of next month, like our.
In 2018, Wu Jihan became a self-made billionaire with a net worth of $2.3 billion, but the price of Bitcoin collapsed. 2018 was a disastrous year for Bitcoin as its stock prices plummeted. The result was Bitmain's IPO expired in March 2019. Two things happened. First, Wu Jihan stepped down as CEO of Bitmain. Second, Wang Haichao took over as CEO of Bitmain. It's an internal promotion. What have I learned today? From the story of Wu Jihan and Bitmain, I learned big money is made when the public either does not believe in the new thing or completely misunderstand it. This is the case of Bitcoin in 2013. Thank you for watching. Please subscribe and leave your questions and comments below. My next video will be Wu Jihan 10 Lessons. Wishing everyone peace and prosperity.